George Macharia is a fourth-year student at the University of Nairobi. He's among many students in the campus who faced the wrath of anti-riot police. On Thursday, University of Nairobi students took to the streets to demand the release of Embakasi East MP Babu Owino. In the melee, JSU officers gained entry into the campus and unleashed terror on the students. George says he was going back to the hostel after morning classes when tragedy struck.
Wakarushatia gas canister from that side. So ilikuja ikaland kwa mguu, ikalipukia kwa mguu yangu. So ilipasuka. Nini? Kuna place ilipasuka hivi. Ikafunguka, so nilienda kuangatibiwa.
Simon Githua too was not spared.
We were in Mamlaka B, room 26. We were just relaxing there with my friend. Then the GSU came and broke into our room. And they started beating us. For me, they beat me here at the left hand, at the right hand, and also here at the back, at around the spinal cord. And then they, because I was unable to walk at that moment, then the school ambulance came and took me to Kenyatta National Hospital, where I was treated and I was discharged today in the morning at around 2 a.m. That's impunity, in fact.
Video clips show policemen using batons, whips, and even kicks on defenseless students, most lying on the ground. Students claim police in anti-riot gear evicted them from their hostels, classes, and library before forcing them to lie down on the floor where the beating happened.
I was in the halls of residence, and they really came in for us. In fact, they were coming in with tear gas canisters. I was assaulted. I was hit by a baton on my back. They really beat me thoroughly.
In one of the pictures, a student was hit by the police until he blacked out. In yet another photo, a group of students can be seen carrying an injured colleague who had allegedly been beaten by GSU. Some students indicated they were either leaving classes or hostels when they were caught in the drama. Female students who are not participating in the riots were also not spared. The students claim anti-riot police also looted and destroyed property.
The policemen were spraying the poisonous water inside the students' rooms and hostels, you see, because some students, they were not even participating in the peaceful demonstration.
Some of the students are lying in the hospitals. They are seriously injured.
Even the security officers, they were on their job and they were also attacked. Three of them were hospitalized. So we were wondering, what had they done? So they were victimizing everybody, getting into the rooms, destroying property. They break the doors.
Student officials say they did not know how and why the officers were allowed to access their hostels and classes.
The GSU or other external security officers are not allowed to access the university presence at whatever level. We are very much surprised that yesterday the administration colluded with the external security to enter into the university presence and harass our students. Our students were beaten, ladies were sexually assaulted, and nothing has been done so far. And therefore, we are asking the Vice Chancellor of the University of Nairobi, Professor Peter Mbithi, that by today evening we want to hear a statement from him explaining clearly why he allowed external security officers in the name of GSU.
We are not criminals. This is an institution of higher learning.
Library, the GSU officers stepped in and looted all the laptops inside there. They beat students and took away their phones. Money. Up to now, students have lost money to a tune of 1 million shillings.
This has been something which has been going on for a while. In 2016, they were here. In 2015, they were here.
They further called upon the university administration to put in place mechanisms to ensure that such incidents do not recur and ensure the safety and security of all students under their care. Rose Ongoi, NTV.